Within the first few minutes after the injury, platelets aggregate at the injury site to form a fibrin-fibronectin plug, which reduces active bleeding. During the inflammation phase, bacteria and cell debris are phagocytes and removed from the wound by polymorphonuclear neutrophils and macrophages. Blood factors are released into the wound that cause the migration and division of cells during the proliferative phase. The proliferation phase is characterized by angiogenesis, collagen deposition, granulation tissue formation, epithelialization, and wound contraction. In angiogenesis, vascular endothelial cells form new blood vessels. In fibroplasia and granulation tissue formation, fibroblasts grow and form a new provisional extracellular matrix, ECM, by excreting collagen and fibronectin. Re-epithelialization of the epidermis occurs, whereby epithelial cells proliferate and crawl atop the wound bed, covering the new tissue. During wound contraction, myofibroblasts decrease the size of the wound by gripping the wound edges and contracting, using a mechanism that resembles that of smooth muscle cells. When the cells' roles are close to completion, unneeded cells undergo apoptosis. During maturation and remodeling, collagen is remodeled and realigned along tension lines. The onset of the maturation phase may vary depending on the size of the wound and whether it was initially closed or open, ranging from 3 days to 3 weeks. As the phase progresses, the strength of the wound increases, with the strength approaching 50% that of normal tissue by 3 months after injury, and ultimately becoming as much as 80% as strong as normal tissue. Since activity at the wound site is reduced, the scar loses its red appearance as blood vessels that are no longer needed are removed.